everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. In America's heartland, when you come to Lincoln, there is a sea of red. Memorial Stadium, the host today for our showdown. Players getting set, coaches starting to feel a little bit on edge as we close in on kickoff. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Fred Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
The Sooners versus the Huskers in this classic rivalry game.
And now let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. That quickly incomplete.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. They go with a screen, incomplete.
Sims was the intended receiver on the play. That brings us third and 10.
Knocked out immediately after the catch.
Great effort here by the wideout to secure the ball and pick up some extra yardage.
Get him! Get him! Get him! Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53!
Up, up, and up! Has some daylight.
Makes it out to about the 46.
Call it a gain of 9 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
Runs it left for a decent game. So the option keeper will get him a first down.
It's a very well executed option play. The blocking was there, and the quarterback made the correct decision to keep it himself and get the first down.
And a quick throw, and he's taken down at the 34.
That'll make it second and four.
He's tackled at the 38. The quarterback tried to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. At the 23.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Tight end right.
gets out to about the 11-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
And down he goes at the 8-yard line. Gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Touchdown, OU. The PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Time to go to the Little Apple in Manhattan. This was a tight one to the very end. Memphis grabs the W by a touchdown. In other games, the Hawkeyes were ranked 24th. Now the loss is likely to knock them out of the polls. It felt as if the game rested on every play. Wake Forest gets the win by 7.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Right, ready to kick. He just drills this one. And they can forget about returning this one. Nebraska's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line, and, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that you throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Oh, picks him up about 3 yards with a catch. Third down. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He's scrambling. Brought down at about the 35. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Just a great job by the defense. These guys are disguising their defense so well that they're confusing the quarterback and the offensive line.
Lewis to punt. Lawson takes it to 25, and he just got drilled. The Sooners really got the job done on that first drive, and they took the crowd out of this thing.
They sure did, and I was really impressed with the execution by the quarterback. It's tough to be able to communicate with your linemen and not to mention your wide receivers. I thought he did a very nice job of showing great poise, keeping his composure, and leading them to some points. We'll see what he can do here this next time out.
Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set. Throws complete, and he's hit right away.
Number 34 makes the set at the 40-yard line. That'll bring up third and 6.
Oklahoma is up 7. Fires out to his wideout. They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback.
Hey,
They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's out of bounds around the 48-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. He's taken down at the 35-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. And they push him out right around the 34. And he can't get away from the pressure. So at the end of one quarter, the Sooners lead 7-0. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Oklahoma is up a score. He lets it fly. Alston looking to get some distance on this one and give his team the field position advantage. He's tackled at the 15-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
It's second and nine. Ball on the 16-yard line. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line. Stop at the 32.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. They come out on an empty backfield. He makes his way to about the 48. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. Quick throw. And he's tackled at the 31. The defender wanted a head start, and they certainly got him for it.
Defense.
So a nice little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a first down.
That was a very good-looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Tackled for a loss.
The way the safety was playing up toward the line of scrimmage shows you what they think of the offense's passing game. Not a lot of respect for it.
You're going to see me in your nightmares, son. You're going to see me in your nightmares.
Gets to about the 34-yard line.
Nowhere to go on the delay.
That brings up third and 12.
This is the eighth play of this drive. There's a strike complete. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he converts the extra point. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The Longhorns come into today's game ranked fourth, hoping a win can move them up in the rankings. The Cowboys continuing to pound the rock on the ground and score a touchdown. And for Tucker, he's tossed a couple of touchdown passes. Texas on top, 21-9.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the one. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. He has some room. Gets out to around the 38.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
After a decent run up the gut. Sims gained 7 yards on that play. Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. First down.
Brought down immediately. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
First and 10.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's taken down around the 16-yard line. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
He's got an opening. Up the middle for a nice game. He keeps it on the option and picks up maybe four. The Sooners are going to call their second timeout. This is the ninth play of this drive. Makes the catch and look out. And he shoved out of bounds at the 3.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The Sooners lose one of their key players with that injury earlier. Still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon. Touchdown, Sooners. The extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Time to get you up to date on some scores from around the country. This is a game we've been watching closely today. The Longhorns have the lead, 24-9.
All right, thanks, Reese. Right, as the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep.
Kid back to return.
Kid from the four, brought down at the 25.
The Cornhuskers know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
He scrambled. They bring him down. He's on the run. He's tackled
at about the 31.
And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He gets out to about the 42-yard line.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
Oklahoma up 7 points. He's under pressure, and he's going to come up with a sack. We've played a half of football here. Oklahoma's lead is a touchdown.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. A tight, hard-hitting, low-scoring affair.
Great
affair.
This great.
Is right,
you can say it like it is.
This is right in your wheelhouse, Pollack. I mean, this is exactly in your comfort zone.
No, absolutely. I mean, you like to see people flying around. You like to see defenses dictating to offenses and make them play on our terms. And it's fun to watch. It's something that every great defense prides themselves on tackling. You know, you didn't see very many missed tackles in the first half that led to big plays. And try to limit those big plays. And when they do get down towards the red zone, make people kick field goals. And that's how you see dominant defenses year in, year out. And that's what we're seeing today.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He sends this one deep. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And they'll get him in the backfield. 2-yard loss for the halfback.
Loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up second and 12.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Now he tries to buy some time. They'll make the sack. The pressure got to him that time.
Now they brought the heat here, and the linebacker was able to spring free for a big play.
Third down, 12 yards to go. Ball in the 23.
Oklahoma.
Over the middle to his tailback. And he hits him hard at the 22. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little.
The defense is going to head to the sideline with a real sense of accomplishment. knowing that they've just shut this offense down.
Lewis is the punter. And he's taken down at the 49.
When he made the decision to return the ball, I'm sure he thought there was going to be some room to run. But boy, did it vanish in a hurry. Still, he got something out of it.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Oklahoma is up by a touchdown. He's at the 40, keeps his eye on it, makes the catch. And down he goes at the 31-yard line.
First down.
Here we go, D. Here I come. Here I come. Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53.
Yeah. Yeah.
Check, 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 check.
Gets him open field. Nice run up the middle. He's on the run. Nice run there.
Makes the tackle. Gain of 5 yards. First down.
He gets out to about the 8.
Gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Hey, we got to get the stop here, D. Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53.
Check,
check, check, check, check, check, check, check.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Down for a loss. The quarterback decided to pitch it on the option, but the back had nowhere to go.
Just a perfect defensive scheme for stopping that. They got to the option before it got to them.
Well, let's see what they do here. It's 3rd and goal from the 6. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. Dumps it across the middle. Caught for the touchdown. So he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 7-play, 49-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Oklahoma's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Here he goes! Makes it out to about the 39.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Stewart on the handoff. Makes it out to about the 50. First and 10. Ball on the 50.
scrambling around. He's at the 40. Tackle at about the 35.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
From the 35-yard line, first down. He's going to try and scramble. Brought down
at about the 27-yard line.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. It's first and 10. Ball on the 21. That's a great tackle at the 23.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Second and 12.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Tackle made at the 16.
Lead with the tackle at the 16-yard line. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 21-7, Oklahoma. He's got it out to his tight end. And he's tackled
around the 5-yard line.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
And he tacks on the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Time to get you up to date on what's going on in Houston. And for Louisiana Tech, let's keep an eye on this game where a major surprise could be brewing. The Owls have the lead by 13, midway through the fourth quarter.
Reese, a touchdown difference in this one, 21-14. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. The finish line's in sight. Let's see who wants this one more.
Brad, at this point, this defense has to do everything in their power to try to strip that ball away, to get the ball back to their own offense, to see if they can get a chance to win this game.
He's taken down at the 30-yard line. About a 5-yard pickup on the old play-action pass.
That brings him second and 5.
Oklahoma is up 7. Tackled right away.
That's a deep 9 on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 57. Check.
And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 39-yard line, it's 2nd down. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
Turner brings him down at the 46-yard line. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this 5 wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. He's out of bounds at about the 49.
gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. And they make the stop at the 32. First and 10. Ball on their own 32. To the 40. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. He goes down at the 22. So it's first and 10 after the big run. Screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Now he's scrambling, and he's taken down at the 10-yard line. First down, 10 to go. 10 yards to the end zone. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Throws middle to the tight end. He's tackled at the 5-yard line.
That brings him second and 5.
Pressured and brought down.
That is a loss of 7. That brings up third and 12.
It's third down and long, and losing by a possession, I would expect them to have to go to the air. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. Here's the call from the referee.
Delayed game, offense.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. Nebraska lines up for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Throws it to the halfback on the screen.
And he tackles him hard at the 27. He wants it all. And he is drilled at the 44-yard line. Down of bounds at the 27-yard line. First down. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 27. Quick throw, and down he goes at the 24-yard line. And he's immediately tackled. From the 11-yard line, it's first down. He tackles him for a loss. Oklahoma's going to use their first time out of the half here. Give to the tailback. Gets to about the 11-yard line. Sims picks up a yard on the play. The Sooners use their second timeout. This is the eighth play of this drive. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. So it's coming down to the kicking game. This to give them the lead. It's up, and he got it! Game over! And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
We had a fight to the finish here today. 24-21, Oklahoma. As we wrap this game up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
Nothing adds to the pageantry of college football more than a good rivalry. This was a great game that should only add more fuel to the fire for next year's matchup, and boy, was it fun to watch.
Brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.